Hello, everybody. You're probably wondering what I'm doing today. Or you're not. You're probably not. But, you know, I can't tell if this is straight. Whatever. Oh, my closet door is open. But you can see my panic poster. So, we'll leave it open. Today, I am going to be making a Naruto tier list. Because I grew up watching Naruto. I rewatched the first series, the Shonen Jump series, like summer after my freshman year of college, and then I started watching Shippuden through my sophomore year to last summer. So that took a while to get through because it's like 500 episodes, and with the Shonen Jump series, it's like 600. Except Netflix took out all the fillers at the end, so like if you missed it, you missed it. I'm sorry. But today, I'm going to be doing a tier list, and I'm excited. And this is my tier list. I got this idea from, well, I didn't really get the idea. I saw Swag Kage did a video where he used this tier list and then linked it. And I was like, I want to make a tier list. So like, it's obviously not an original idea. I didn't make the tiers. I didn't pick the people. He did. So I'm just going to make my list based on my feelings of these individuals. So if you want to do that, I will link this tier list down below. I will also link his video down below because like I said, I didn't make this video idea. I'm not original. I just wanted to do it because I love Naruto. So, we're gonna start. First up is Mizuki. I'm not really sure how I feel necessarily about him, but he's kind of a hard one to start with because he was like at the very beginning. So, I'm going to put him in... C tier for right now. And then we have Gaara. And Gaara deserved better the whole time. So, but he wasn't really too much of a villain because he had his arc where he was the villain and that was the Chunin exams. And then he went through his whole like turnaround where Naruto really reached into his soul and was like, hey, it's okay. I love you. And I'm like, that's so cute. But as far as like, if Gaara would have been completely evil the whole time, he's almost untouchable with his sand barrier, so I'm gonna put him in B tier for right now. He might move. They all might move, but for right now, that's what we're going with. Kabuto. I watched the Chunin exam arc for the first time when I was really young, and I was like, oh my gosh, Kabuto's so good and wholesome, and like, little did I know, he's actually freaking evil. For whatever reason, like, I didn't remember him being bad, and I watched it back through, and I was like, wait, what? So I'm gonna put him with Mizuki in C tier, because I feel like in this arc, he didn't really peak as a villain. Like, he was cunning, and he was sneaky, and he was arrogant, and all of that stuff, but not as much as he was when he was Snake Boy. So I'm in C tier for right now. So next we have Orochimaru, the man, the myth, the legend. I'm going to put him in A tier, because he was basically the main villain of the whole, like, beginning arc. He's the whole reason Sasuke freaking left the Leaf Village. Without Sasuke leaving the Leaf Village, we wouldn't really have much of a story. Now, would we? So I'm gonna put him in A tier. Specifically, he might move up to S tier, to be fair. We'll see who else ends up in A tier and how I feel about that. So, next we have Itachi. My boy. I love Itachi with all of my freaking heart. So Itachi gets to go to S tier because I said so, and that's just how I feel. He's not the best villain. I just think he deserved better. Better than Gaara. Because Gaara had a tragic backstory, but like, Itachi had to kill his whole family for like, no reason, and he really loved his little brother. And I resonate with that, because I also love my little brother, and I would do anything for him, especially not kill my entire family. I'm not even gonna go there. I would not kill my entire family for my brother, or for my village, or whatever, but Itachi just has a special place in my heart. And you know what? When he and Sasuke had their final battle in Shippuden together, and like, he got all of the information that he ever wanted, ugh, my heart was breaking. Also, now that before I continue, I'm really sorry that I have a window here and two windows here and none right here. But that's just how it's gonna be, and I wanted to sit at my desk because I don't really have much of a background anywhere else. You can see my light bulbs here and my panic poster here and my clothes here. And my blanket and messy bed and the, like, packing right here. But that's just how this is gonna go. So, thanks. Next we have Kisame. who honestly would have been a super intense villain, especially if he wasn't with Itachi. Because he's just like, Itachi, what do you want to do? And Itachi's like, I don't know, man. I'm not even really that evil. But Kisame was kind of a force to be reckoned with. Like, I was a little bit scared of him. Like, if he ever decided to act out on his own, especially with Samihara. Oof, that boy. He's going in A tier. And then we have the Sound Ninja Four. Jirobo, Kidomaru, Sekon Yukon, and Tayuya. Now, for me, they all kind of belong together in a tier because they were pretty good. I'm gonna put them in C tier with Mizuki has to go down to D tier. I'm sorry. He can't stay up there with these guys. I'm gonna put them all together because they kinda go with Kabuto too. Sorry, Tayuya. There. They just kinda all go together for me. Like, they were intense and I was scared of them and they took Sasuke and there was that whole thing, but like, I couldn't really differentiate between much of them based on skill, given that it has been like 3 years since I've watched any of that part. I am going back through and rewatching, but I've only made it to like the end of the Chunin exams and Gaara just snapped, so I'm not that far into it yet. And I started reading the manga and I'm about in that same point too, but I've had to take a break from that because I'm moving. So bear with me. Next we have Kimimaru, and I'm gonna put him in B tier because he really could have had a lot of potential, but I feel like he was never used to his full potential. I think it was because he was sick. I can't remember though. Why am I blanking out on so much of this? I don't know, but he's in B tier and that's just how it is. So if you don't like it, go make one yourself. Anyway, we can't do one of the Demon Brothers without the other. So we're gonna drag them both to F tier because they got beat by Sasuke as a genin. So, irrelevant. They are nothing. Before we do Zetsu, I'm gonna do these two clowns. Because I also don't remember them. So they can go on F tier with the Demon Brothers because I don't want to deal with them. And then we have Zetsu. Zetsu, I'm going to put in... Where do I want to put him? I'm gonna come back to him because I don't know. We're gonna do Sasori and Deidara as a package deal for right now because they kind of are. Sasori, I'm gonna put in S tier because I love him, and Deidara, I'm gonna put in A tier because I feel like I can't put them in the same tier. Sasori really wrecked everybody in that first season, and Deidara took Gaara, so I feel like he belongs in A tier because he is powerful, but like, he's just not Sasori. And Sasori was a force to be reckoned with all of his freaking puppets. That really scared me. I did not like that. I was also like 19 when I watched it, but I was like, how are you gonna steal everyone's body when they die? That's freaking rude. Okay, we're gonna come back to Zetsu now since I've dealt with these two. Zetsu, he was more of a spy when he was in this form. So I'm gonna put him in D tier for right now because I want to. That's why. Toby, I'm gonna put in C tier because he was just kind of like comic relief for me. I didn't really see him as much of a threat until he went through his drastic transformation. Hidan and Kakuzu are kind of a package deal because they were in the fight with Asuma, Shikamaru, and the other two who are like always in there but whose names I literally always forget. What are their names? I'm not gonna look right now. I will look later. I will let you know. I will put it probably like along this bottom line. I'll let you know. But they were in the fight that killed Asuma, and I wanna put... They can go on the same tier because I feel like their powers were both pretty scary. And by scary, I mean I didn't know how our boys were gonna handle it. And then Hidan really messed up Asuma and I was sad. And then Kakuzu was the one with all the hearts. So I'm gonna put them in B tier because they were much better than Deidara. I don't know why I feel like I want to keep Deidara in A tier. He's moving down to B and they are going to A because they were scary and they were intense. And then we have Pain and Konan. Pain is gonna go up to S tier because I liked their story and I liked that. And Konan's gonna go to B tier because I said so. Pain / Nagato really did me dirty in my brain, and he killed Jiraiya. How freaking dare. But he was super powerful and really scary. And I was like, I don't know how they're going to get out of this one. But they always end up doing it. But I liked seeing, Hinata pop out for that fight and help Naruto with Pain, even though Naruto single-handedly, like, beat him. I almost said beated him. That would not have been right. And then Konan, she would have been a phenomenal villain, I think. Like, a strong woman character. I really wanted her to do that. But then again, she was just kind of like Nagato's right-hand lady. So I feel like she wasn't really used to her full potential. But that's just me. Hanzo, I remember you, but not that much, so you can go in D tier. Obito, he gonna go up to S tier because he had a tragic backstory and really, like, messed everyone up. And I felt bad for him. This is a really even tier list, and I don't like how it looks. But I'm doing it based on my feelings, so I should explain. I'm gonna put the next three people in D tier because, you know what? Bye. Because I put Danzo, Ginkaku, and Ginkaku, who both, I don't know the difference between them. I just know that they were together and they had, like, the pot and the other thing that put the souls in there. They were annoying. I didn't like them. They weren't even that big of villains. They were just kind of, like, there for 5 minutes and then they were defeated and I was like, whatever. And then Danzo can move up to C tier. Fine. Fine. He can move up to C tier. Because he freaking was creepy and I didn't like it. And he had all the eyes on his arm and that was just too much. And I'm surprised. How did the village elders not pick up that he was freaking insane? Honestly, I was so mad about that. I was like, he's crazy. He is clearly crazy. And they were like, no, he's great. Also, I'm gonna move Sasori down to A tier. I can't put him in the same ballpark as Pain and Obito. Itachi is staying in S tier, and I don't care if you're mad about it, because that's where he's staying, and that's what I said. I love Itachi, and I don't care. That's looking a little bit better now that it's not all, like, four blocked down. Now we have Kabuto Snake Boy. I'm gonna put him in A tier as well, because he activated the Edo Tensei, so he clearly is out here doing something. He is the whole reason that the war arc happened. Like, the whole war arc, the way it all overlapped, it just seemed like there were too many power hungry players and then that was never gonna work. And guess what? It didn't work. But there was, like, Obito, Madara, and Kabuto all together, but all competing and all wanting to, like, be the winners of this trial. Like, they didn't want to, like, benefit the other people in any way. They just wanted to benefit themselves, clearly, which is what every evil character wants to do. But, like, they all were together doing it, and so it was just weird. Madara's going up to S tier. I don't care. Because he was just overpowered. And he can't be anywhere else but S tier. But he was overpowered, and he, like, had the first Hokage's face on him, so then he had both their powers, and it was just too much. And then there was the Ten Tails, who I'm gonna put in C tier, because he's not really, like, a villain. He's just kind of like a weapon of mass destruction, let's be honest. Indra, I'm going to put in C tier, because he's fine. I didn't really see him. I saw him as, like, a villain, but not as much of a villain as some of the other characters. Please don't come for me for Itachi. I know he's an S tier, okay? But I just feel like they dropped Indra and Ashura into Naruto as a whole. And I was like, why are they here? What do they contribute to this story? Like, it just made another plot hole for Sasuke and Naruto to fall right into. Or not plot hole, but, like, plot line. They were like, oh, Sasuke and Naruto. They're just really driving home that Sasuke and Naruto are parallels and that they are basically brothers. Because they're alone. And now we have Zetsu, whiny baby Zetsu, who was like, Mom, help me. Help me, Kaguya. You can go in D tier, my guy, because you really weren't that great of a villain. You were just kind of a little. I'll edit that out. Kaguya can go into B tier because she was still pretty scary. Gato can go into F tier because he didn't do anything. He literally didn't. He was like, Zabuza, go get my stuff. and or go kill the bridge builder or whatever. And then they killed him and it was over, and nobody else from his like company or organization or whatever he was doing like came for anyone. They were just like, that's fine, I guess, whatever. Sasuke as a villain. Sasuke can go in C tier, B tier. We'll move Sasuke in a minute. He like was a good villain, but he just seemed like a confused teenage boy. Oh wait, he was a confused teenage boy because he was told that his brother was evil, but his brother was just misunderstood. Love you, Itachi. Anyway, Sasuke just didn't have all the information that he needed to make his decisions, which is why I think he's such a complicated villain to place. So, the next villain, I've seen like a snippet. I haven't actually seen the movie that he's in, so I don't have enough information, so I'm just gonna leave him down there for right now. I might add him in, I might not, but I feel like I don't have enough information to make a decision because that's like the only movie I haven't seen because it wasn't on Netflix. I've watched all the other ones, but yeah, and then this guy can go into D tier because I don't want to deal with him. That'll tell you how much I actually know about him, but I remember seeing him. I just don't really have any memory of like what he did. Zabuza, oh my gosh, Zabuza and Haku can go in A tier. I don't even care. I love them so much. They were heartbreaking, and Zabuza was like, I don't have any feelings, I'm a demon. And I was like, boy, watch your life. I don't know what you mean. But Zabuza really loved Haku, and Haku was super powerful, so we'll leave that. I have like 3 minutes before my thing comes, and we still have so many more characters. So this guy can go in F tier because he kind of sucked and didn't really do much. We have Dosu, Rin, and Rin. Rin is not her. Keen, Dosu, and Zaku. I'm going to put... you can go here, you can go here, and you can go with her. You can go in B tier, and you can also go in B tier because I said so, and I'm just going to put this guy. I want to put him somewhere. You can go in C tier because I think you were good, and I think that that looks the best for me. So, I guess I have time to talk about why I think Keen and Zaku. No, you know what? Dosu can go down with them because they're a team, and they did their thing, and whatever. No, you know what? Kaguya can go down to C tier, and this guy, Kinshiki, can go to C tier, and Momoshiki can stay up there, and I'm gonna actually put Kaguya back up there. Just kidding. Sorry, but here's my tier list. Thanks for watching. I made very uneducated opinions about why I think these villains should be here. Because I decided that I was going to do it based on my feelings instead of facts. Because that's sometimes how you have to make your decisions, based on your feelings and not facts. Don't actually do that. Only do that for things that don't really matter, like this. This is not going to hurt my life because I made opinions based on my feelings. Itachi belongs in the S tier. Itachi can go in S plus. I don't care who you are. If you want to come for me about Itachi, go ahead. I love him. His story spoke to me in ways that no one else's did, and I just don't want to hear about it. Itachi belongs in the S tier. Realistically, he can go down to C tier with his brother for villain-esque stuff. No, B tier. He can go to B tier, but I'm leaving him an S. So, thanks for watching. Hit me with a sub if you want to. I don't know why you would, but if you want to, thank you for watching. Goodbye.